One of the things that we're exploring is how people understand society and how they deploy concepts in understanding a society. And some of these concepts are like the concept of employment or unemployment. You know, in between, you can even have underemployment. Now, here we are dealing with very serious mindset issues, you know, very serious mindset issues in the sense that young people, together with their parents, when they are undertaking the process of, enrolling, especially when young people are being enrolled in school, their parents have in their mind one thing, that my child must complete learning and then be employed. Be employed by who? Be employed by government in the first place. The government is the first choice, you know, employer. Then why? Because with the government, there are very many advantages. You get employed, and when you are sick, they give you leave. They can even pay you even when you are on leave, you know. Probably depending on where you are employed, you can even be given other health insurance issues. So the first priority of everybody is be employed by government. But of course, the private sector is also another employer. So every parent that sends a child to school wants the child to be employed by government or at worst by the private sector, by the NGOs and you know what. Now, when you talk of employment, employment is not only provided by those two agencies. Employment is not only within the public and then the private sector. Employment is actually, everywhere. I have been talking to young people. I have one who told me that I am not going to look for a job. By that time, he was studying economics and statistics in Kiambogo University. This young man told me that I am not going to look for a job. And he has lived to his promise. 4 years after completing university, this young man has not looked for anybody's job, but he is employed. He considers himself employed. But you see, there are not so many young people who think like that. There are others who are still looking for a job even after 10 years of completing university or college. You know, they are still looking for a job. They are hopeful that one day they will get a job. Some of them have become so desperate. But I know there are those that think that, they have a different interpretation of what a job is or of what employment is. In fact, a young man recently, another one, about 3 days ago, told us that nobody can employ him. I asked him why. He said, because I have offered myself a job through my own thinking and creativity. In a month, I get like 3 to 5 million. 3 to 3.5 million, you know. And I said, but there are people who get much more money than that. He said, yes, but I have my freedom. You know, you have not quantified my freedom. So what I'm trying to say here is that what exactly is this thing called employment? You know, who provides employment? And that is why I said this is a very complicated mindset problem, which also needs a mindset solution, you know, a mindset solution. So that we find, even right now, if you go to urban places, you find, you know, young people. Some of them are carrying, envelopes with very serious credentials. They're looking for a job, you know. They're trying to go to their tall relatives to connect them. You know, one of the languages that have evolved, one of the words that have evolved is connection. You know, connection. Connection means you're looking to a politician, you're looking to a well-placed relative, you're looking to, you know, people who matter in society to try to fix you in a job. But is that what it is? My perception is that education should actually place you at a vantage position from which you can navigate your way around society and opportunities. There are very many contradictions, but how you position yourself is very important. So youth employment, youth unemployment is a very serious question that we have to deal with. But if we are to do that, we have to deal with a very serious mindset question. It requires a mindset solution. Employment is everywhere, if you want my executive summary.